Yeah, I have sent it.
Okay. So this is also a warm-up activity only. You need to know how to use a screw gauge for your ISC practicals, right? So today's experiment aim is to determine the diameter of the given wire. So this is the wire which has been given to you using a screw gauge. So the screw gauge given to you will definitely have a zero error. 95% of probability is there. So if there is a negative zero error, do a positive correction. If there is a positive zero error, do a negative correction. Okay, and then note down the correct value of diameter. So here on the right hand side of the page, the rule side, all these are labeled items represent. And on the unruled side, which is left hand side of the record, all these L labeled items should be present. And on the unruled side, use only pencil, do not use pen. Are you listening? Fire.
Yes, sir.
Afterwards, don't mess up the instructions. The unruled side, you have to write with pencil or pen?
Pencil.
Okay, so after aim, so these are straight away taken from the syllabus. We have some around 12 experiments to do after the syllabus, so we are doing that. So after this will be what?
Screw gauge and wire,
that's it. Procedure?
Measure.
Okay, I want someone to make an attempt. Shaurya, make an attempt. Explain what you write in the procedure. Step by step.
Measure the diameter of the wire. Measure the diameter of the wire using a screw gauge.
Calculate.
Four times. Wait, 1%. And note down the values in the
operation. Take 4 dials and take the mean of the value.
3 dials is enough.
3
dials
enough.
And then at 3 different locations. See, the wire could have non-uniform thickness. So you need the average diameter of the wire. So at 3 different locations, measure the diameter of the wire. Okay?
And then so using the formula, calculate the area of
the diameter of the wire was measured using the screw gauge at 3 different locations and noted in the observation table. But this is not the first step. The first step is
measure the
noted the least count of the screw gauge.
So first pitch.
And then note, no, that means it is least count is pitch, right? Which is obviously known to the gauge, it's 1 millimeter. See, least count of the screw gauge you note down here, how many centimeters you can measure.
Which is distance divided through by number of rotations given. So you can give up in the major as a first step.
That's why I have sent it only for diagram purpose. To draw the diagram of the apparatus. Okay? Instructions you just write like this, the way I am doing. So least count of screw gauge you all know, right? How much?
0.001
centimeter. Zero error is? It will not coincide, the zero of the circular scale division will not coincide
with
the
circular line. So, coinciding with 60, right now it's zero.
You have to see when it becomes zero. If you increase the gap from 60 after, if you increase the gap, then it becomes to zero, then it comes to zero. Okay? That means you have to move it 40 divisions forward before it comes to zero.
60 divisions.
No, if the current coincident division is 60, you have to move it from 60 to 100 and then it comes to 0 suppose. Then that means you have to move it ahead by 40 circular scale division. Only then it reaches 0. Which it was supposed to show earlier.
0.0.
Which is negative error.
So that means the error was minus 40 circular scale division. And the correction will be plus 40 circular scale division. Are you getting it? Clear? If it is already ahead by 40 circular scale division. When it is supposed to show 0. That means we'll do it as per the in the simulation we'll see all the types of errors. And then it will be clear. Right? Now just note down how to write the record. Then we'll do some practice with positive zero error, negative zero error on the computer. Then it will be very clear.
Sir,
okay?
Procedure.
So the procedure you will write, the least count of the screw gauge was noted. Then the zero error was noted, zero correction was noted. Then the diameter was noted 3 times, mean was calculated. And then,
that's
it. Here, then you will do this table in the Angul side. Calculation of area, you will do it and write it here.
So I do it in the Angul side.
Yeah, Angul side only. So area is this. So area is equal to this many centimeters square. Now, when you use calculator, it will give you so many decimal values. You should not write to whatever decimal values it shows, the calculator.
Please come at the.
So first note it down. And then after you find delta A, you have to round it off to one significant figure. Vijay Aditya Sukas. Suppose your calculator says the area is 1.345678 cm square. You should not write it like that. You have to make noting it down here, just note it in the report, and then after you find delta A, if delta A is 0.0123 something, then round it off to one significant figure, say 0.01. Okay? And then if that 0.01 is for two decimal values, then this area has to be rounded off to two decimal values. And that is what will be reported here. This number should have one significant figure, and whatever decimal places it has, that means decimal places this will have. Clear or not?
Yes, sir.
So all these calculations should be clear to you. Okay. So now
this screw gauge ka LC 0.01.
0.001 centimeter.
Sir.
Okay, see here, this is where it's a bit confusing. Listen carefully. Dada, Ashorya, listen carefully.
Ashorya,
see here, when it is actually supposed to show 0, that means this 0 division is supposed to coincide with this horizontal line of the main scale, because there is no gap here, right? It is supposed to coincide. But instead, what you find, 0 is slightly above in this case. That means you have to remember, anything above 0 is the positive scale, anything below 0 is the negative scale. You have to remember that. Okay? So right now the actual coincident division is not 98. It is actually minus 2 circular scale divisions. The actual reading of this is minus 2 circular scale division, not 98 circular scale division. It will be 98 circular scale division if I rotated it and from a starting position it moved by 98 divisions. Then it would have been 98 circular scale divisions. Are you getting it? So now another way of understanding, so now since the zero error is minus 2 circular scale division, the zero correction has to be to cancel this error. So it should be plus 2 circular scale division. Okay, so let us see how it will make sense, this kind of approach. So now to actually make it 0, I need to increase the gap. Right? So I have to turn it downwards so that the gap is increased by 2 divisions. Then the 0 will finally coincide. The 0 will come here. So now there is actually a gap here of 2 circular scale divisions, but my instrument shows 0. So suppose the wire which I was measuring, whose diameter I was measuring, had a thickness of exactly 2 circular scale divisions, then its actual thickness was supposed to be 0.002 centimeter, but my instrument would have read 0. So how do I correct my measurement? I will add this. So if it was showing 0 as the constant circular scale division, I do a correction of plus 2, so then plus 2 into least count of 0.001, my reading will become 0.002, the correct value. Are you getting it? Now, one reason why there will be confusion is, in this scenario, this is how it can confuse you. See here, suppose my zero error was, because the coincident earlier, the coincident circular scale division when it showed, when it was supposed to be zero gap, suppose it was 70. Okay. So suppose this was 70. So when there is no gap between the arms, the coincident circular scale division is 70. So what should I note down as the?
So reading CSD.
30 or minus 30. So the actual error, zero error is.
Minus 30
circular scale.
And zero correction is plus.
So zero correction is
plus
30 circular scale division. Now here comes the confusion. When I actually put the wire and note down the reading, suppose my reading, the coincident voltage division is 80. Okay. So now if the mistake, the most common mistake students make is they forget to take it as minus 20. They forget to realize that it has not even crossed zero yet. It has not even reached zero yet. Okay? It is actually showing, this is actually minus 20 circular scale division.
So
if you fail to realize that and the coincident voltage division is 80, it has not crossed the zero mark. It is behind the zero mark and it shows 80. Okay? If it has not crossed the zero mark and it is showing, it is still behind the zero mark and it is showing 80, it means the actual reading is minus 20, not 80. So if you make the mistake of noting this coincident division as 80 itself, and then if you do the zero correction of plus 30, you will go wrong.
So if it is 40,
you have to keep your eye open in this area. When you started, this division of zero mark was not visible. And see, if the zero error was 30, minus 30, the zero error was minus 30, right? That means the original reading was 70 when you started opening it, right? But now it is showing 40, right? So what you can, so you have to check whether before you started this was visible or not. If it was not visible, and now also it is not visible. From 70, how it will go to 40? That means it has crossed the zero mark and gone to 40, right?
So it will plus 40.
So if it has crossed the zero and gone to 40, so the correct reading is actually 40. Are you getting it?
No. Yes.
If that means you would be able to see this division compared to earlier case. When it was actually showing 70 for no gap, okay, this mark would not have been visible. Okay, if you are able to see 40, that means it has crossed this mark.
So it is zero correction to karoge aap.
Yeah, so the actual reading you will take it to be 40 only.
Zero correction.
And then you will do the zero correction of plus 30.
Uh-huh.
And you will get 70.
40 wala nahi samajh aa
raha. See, when there was no gap in our imaginary screw gauge, the coincident division was
70.
Right? So we noted it as minus 30. Now when you are going to keep the wire, okay, from that minus 30 it has gone to 0 and then it has gone to plus 40. Are you getting it? So now you should note down the reading as plus 40 only. Are you getting it? So if the reading is plus 40, the correction is plus 30. So plus 40 plus 30. Plus 70
circles. Okay, so basically, we are just saying that you always have to take the reading from 0 to whatever your values come, and then you have to add up the correction.
Yes. So you have to be very careful to see whether, like, what is the actual reading? Is it a negative reading or is it a positive reading? You have to be careful about that. Are you getting it?
Can you start doing it up?
So this reading, let us try this reading.
So can you just show another example?
So this one is.
Minus 2.
So we have to do plus 2. So let's see the actual. Let's measure this lead shot. Now, so now what is the reading?
6.
5 millimeter. And you can't see the 6 millimeter. You can't see the 6 millimeter right now.
5.78.
So the actual reading is 0.5, and then two decimal places will be coming from the circular scale division, and it is supposed to be
76
plus 2.
78.
So 17.
That's good.
Correction, zero correction. So, okay, now they are asking the reading in millimeters.
0.002.
No!
Sir, 50 divisions are there.
Are you having least count to cut the side?
Just now I showed you what is the least count.
Yes, sir, that is
listen, wait, calm down. Listen carefully, slowly. The smallest division here is half a millimeter. If you rotate it from 0 to 50 circular scale divisions, you move ahead by another half a millimeter. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
So half millimeter is divided into 50 equal parts.
Yes.
If half millimeter is divided into 50 equal parts, what is each of the divisions on the circular scale division equal to? How long is that? 1 by 50th of a half a millimeter.
0.2.
1 by 50 of half a millimeter is 0.01 millimeter.
No, sir.
1 by 50 of 0.5 is how much?
1 by 50 of
0.5. Take a calculator and look.
0.2.
See, 0.5 divided by 50 equal to 0.01. अब डिवीजन में तुम समझोगे कितना लगा रहा होगा
5 by 500.
सी है 0.5 by 50 इक्वल्स 5 by 500.
यस सर.
इक्वल्स 1 by 100 इक्वल्स 0.01. अब तो बिल करो.
अच्छा, अब तो समझ आ गया सर. आप कह रहे थे वन,
तो वन डिवीजन ऑन सर्कुलर स्केल डिवीजन इज 0.01 मिलीमीटर, विच मीन्स 0.001 सेंटीमीटर. Same like if you had 100 divisions.
No, but we had 50 divisions, that's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, so each division is how much?
Each division, each small division will be 0.002 centimeters.
Least of the formula kya hota
hai? Least
of the formula kya hota
hai? Least count is,
so we can
explain. Sir, the smallest division
is? So
main scale is
smaller division
kya? Main scale ka hai 0.01.
एक सिर्फ
0.5 मिलीमीटर
पॉइंट 50 होगा नंबर ड्यूरेशन का.
हाँ,
क्या होता है वो?
ये बीस का तो पता है यार मुझे. 0.01 मिलीमीटर, बट इधर 50 डिवीजन्स हैं यार.
अरे बेसिकली
व्हेन यू हैव 100 डिवीजन्स यू कुड नॉट नोट डाउन दिस मेन स्केल टू हाफ ए मिलीमीटर एक्यूरेसी. यू कुड ओनली नोट इट डाउन टू 1 मिलीमीटर एक्यूरेसी. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
Whenever your screw gauge has 100 divisions, the main scale will not have these halfway marks between 1 millimeter.
Okay. If I put the screw gauge boost, the one rotation of circular division is 0.01.
For 50 rotations to complete, for 50 circular scale divisions to complete, this will move ahead by half a millimeter, not 1 millimeter. When 100 circular divisions complete, when 100 circular scale divisions complete, it will move from 0 to 1 millimeter. In a screw gauge which has 100 circular scale divisions, when you complete one rotation, that is, when you complete 100 circular scale divisions, this edge will move from 0 to 1. But when your screw gauge has 50 divisions only, it moves ahead by only half a millimeter. So it's exactly identical to the previous screw gauge with 100 divisions. With 100 divisions, you make it move by 1 millimeter. With 50 divisions, you make it move by half millimeter. So for one division of circular scale division, it moves same distance, which is 0.001 centimeter only.
What will be the answer, sir?
So the answer is, now it is 26 circular scale divisions, but correction is -1. So it's 25 circular scale divisions. 25 circular scale divisions multiplied by least count of 0.01 is 0.025. That's why I said these two decimal places will be added from the circular scale. So we have to do 0.025. So it is 0.175
centimeter. So but it should be precise to 0.1. We take it as.
This is the actual measurement. What do you mean?
Oh, that's it.
Screw gauge gives you till 3 decimal places in centimeter.
Yes, sir. That's. I know, sir.
Then you are saying this should be precise, so we have to ask if we have to round off. So 0.175 centimeter. This is 1.75 millimeter. Where are the extra practice questions?
So,
yeah.
So can you please tell us the right answer of this?
If you still know, please the navigation
part. Each one has different wire. How can I know one single answer? I have to check individually your wire.
So what is still like on an average?
I say Eric is a go to the next page.
Huh?
It's written there is a very useful simulation of micrometers.
Yeah, next page.
It's written micrometers simulation. Dragging. Not you, sir.
So let's see how much zero error it has.
It's upper drag mat karo, aise sukhi tarah crack karo.
So when we do the trial, we add the new correction and then try to evaluate.
So zero error nahi aa raha.
So zero likh de raha
zero error.
Zero
error
nahi aa raha.
Zero error. Zero
error. Zero error to hai.
Ab
aa raha. सर अगर ये माइनस एट आ रहा है तो ऊपर पॉजिटिव होगा
एकदम छोटे होगा तो ऑलमोस्ट सबका सही
सर अगर ऊपर होगा सर्कुलेटर स्केल डिवीजन तो पॉजिटिव होगा
क्या
अगर सर्कुलेटर जो सर्कुलर स्केल डिवीजन ऊपर कौन सा ऐड करता है अगर देन जीरो एरर पॉजिटिव होगा
सिमुलेशन इज नॉट प्रॉपर
यार इसमें कुछ हो क्या है सर मैं पूछ रहा हूँ अगर
राइट नाउ
हाँ
द कॉन्सेंट डिवीजन इज नेगेटिव सो जीरो एरर इज नेगेटिव
सो यू विल ऐड
ठीक है This is the zero, above this is positive, below this is negative.
So, but what if we can't see the zero of the circular scale?
If you can't see the zero,
before or after the mark,
that means, so when you can't see the zero, it has gone to this side. So, that means it is negative because only if you move, increase it further, it will come to zero. So if it has gone to the left and it is showing 90, okay, that means if you move it ahead by 10 divisions, only then it will come to 0. So it is actually showing the zero error is actually minus 10. Are you getting it?
Zero error and this is minus 10.
Not in this. Okay, now I will come to each one individually and we will see what is your zero error.
So, start.
Thank you.